welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to be filming this video. I'm sure from the title, you guys might be a little bit curious. Hopefully you are, otherwise you wouldn't have clicked on this video, right? But today I am filming this idea that I had. I was bored one day and I was like, you know what? Everyone's always talking about how many products ColourPop comes out with, and so I thought it would be fun, like YouTube Rewind, if I created a ColourPop Rewind video, because I was genuinely curious as to how many new collections they came out with in the year of 2018. And since it is a fresh new year, I thought this would be the perfect time for us to go over all of their new makeup launches. So what I did was I just went straight to their Instagram account, scrolled all the way back to January 2018 and started screenshotting all their new collections and things like that. I'm pretty sure my list is 100% accurate, but in case you guys think of anything else, definitely let me know down in the comments and things like that. I would love to do more videos like this, but we'll see if you guys like this idea. Let me know all that good stuff down in the comments. So without further blabbering, let's get into it. So I just gotta let you guys know, I do have notes. I have screenshots on my phone. It's a whole thing. So if you see me look down a lot, I do apologize. So the first thing they came out with in 2018 was on January 5th, and it was a Bringing Back Color collection. They did a bunch of Super Shocks. They did 15 Super Shock shades that were some neutrals, but some pastels as well. Just a little bit of color, as ColourPop is known for. Not colorful shades, but like just a little bit, you know? So I have actually stopped buying Super Shock shadows. I didn't buy these ones, and I've pretty much decluttered all of them now out of my collection. I did keep one shade, Telepathy, because I love a good chartreuse. Did not buy anything from that. And then on January 12th of 2018, they came out with a collection called Color Glow. This was 7 Super Shock cheek shades, and I didn't purchase any of those as well. Now, on the 18th of January, they launched 5 new Ultra Matte Lippies, so that was exciting. And on January 25th of last year, they came out with their Give It To Me Straight Palette, as well as their Innuendo Highlight Palette. I did pick up both of those. I have decluttered the Give It To Me Straight Eyeshadow Palette because honestly, it was not getting any use in my collection, and I've kind of come to the conclusion that I just cannot buy every single ColourPop eyeshadow palette. They're coming out with too much and I cannot honestly afford it. And then on the 31st, they launched their first Luxe lipsticks, which was exciting. They did 24 shades, and it's so funny to think of how many shades they've come out with since. But yeah, that was when they first did their Luxe lipsticks, and I think everyone kind of went nuts for those collections. Now going into February, they launched on February 8th, the Moonlight Magic Collection. I don't really remember much of this except the little 6-pan purple eyeshadow palette they came out with. Everyone was going nuts for that. Then they did some Valentine's bundles on Valentine's Day, which was obviously the 14th. And then on 2/16, they did these Luster Dust shades, 5 new Luster Dust. I think that was the first time that product was launched, not 100% sure. Then on 2/22, they announced that they were doing Last Call on the Karrueche collection that they did, which then I'm pretty sure they bought back or something. I can't remember. Okay, and then on 2/25, they launched at Ulta Beauty. So they had some special collections that they did with Ulta. And then on 2/28, they launched Ilari x ColourPop, which I didn't pick up anything from that launch because I'm not really familiar with the collaborator. And then came March, and in March they did on 3/8 the Superstar Loose Shadow collection. I didn't buy any of those either. I just don't like pot shadows and things like that. And then in 3/15, they did the Butterfly collection, which was like their spring collection. Beautiful packaging. I didn't buy any of that either because none of that really interested me. And then in March the 23rd, their last collection of March, was their collab with My Life is Eva, who's like a beauty lifestyle blogger. And it was a beautiful collection, but again, I was not familiar with the collaborator, so I passed on that as well. Okay, so in April, they were busy again, and they did a collection on April 6th called the Festival Collection. Once you guys see the screenshots, I think you'll remember more of what I'm talking about, because honestly, I can't remember either. I did a lot of this research a long, long time ago, actually in 2018, and now I'm filming the video in 2019. So I remember these shades, they were gorgeous. It was a fun collection, and they had some beautiful colors. I actually picked up some of these singles. 420, they had some face and duo. They did some face duos and some lip bundles, and then on 427 is when they first launched the ColourPop x Shayla collection, and I did pick up the eyeshadow palette and like a lippy and a lip gloss from the Makeup Shayla collection. In May, they were celebrating their birthday month, I believe, and 504, they did some new matte luxe lippies. They did like that periwinkle color and some fun new shades. And then on 510, they launched the Fame palette, which was their first ever cool tone palette. And then they did some ultra glossy lips on 525, as well as launching the neutral other half of the Fame palette, which was the Fortune palette. And they also released some face duos on May 31st, and those were all in celebration of their birthday month. Now let's go to June of 2018. They launched the Last Call of the My Little Pony palette and collection on June 8th, and then on June 14th, they did their No Filter foundations. They launched 40 shades. They also launched the No Filter loose setting powders, as well as their sheer pressed powders. And then on June 29th, the Sol and Mar palettes launched as well. I did buy those. I just sold those on Poshmark because honestly, I maybe used those like once or twice in a video, and after that I never touched them, so I thought they deserved a new home. Same with the My Little Pony palette. I'm just trying to make space in my collection, anticipating that they will come out with more things that I may or may not want in 2019. I wasn't getting any use out of the ones I had, so I thought it would be best to just send them on their way. Okay, in July, they launched the Make Up Your Mind palette, which is another cute little six-pan palette. That one was all shimmers, and they did like a poll on their Instagram, and people got to like pick the shades. Then on 7/12, they did the All-Star Primer and the Setting Spray. I passed on both of those because I had previously purchased the setting sprays from their like crystal collection. I don't know if anybody remembers that. And I hated the sprayer on that particular bottle, so I just stay away from ColourPop's primer sprays. And then I just don't really use face primer anyway, so I passed on that. And then 7/26, they did the Kathleen Lights ColourPop Zodiac collection, and I did buy that eyeshadow palette, and it was okay. I didn't love it, and I actually ended up selling that as well on Poshmark. Now we get into August, and the 9th of August, they came out with 6 limited edition Super Shock shades to celebrate 6 million followers on Instagram. On 8/16, they came out with the Jelly Much Shadows 8 shades, and I believe that was the first time those launched. And then on 8/30, they bought back the Karrueche She palette due to popular demand, so you can still buy that on their website. And then on August 30th, they did a back to school collection, which consisted of a few different bundles, nothing I was interested in, stayed away from all of that stuff. Now, September was relatively busy. They did a Shayla round 2 to celebrate Makeup Shayla's birthday, and they did 3 lippies with her. Then they did the fall edit collection, which was to celebrate their fall line, and that came out on September 13th. And my favorite palette of the year came out on September 13th, which was the Good Sport palette. They also had a highlighting palette, some lippies, some eyeshadows, their liquid shadows. I didn't buy any of that stuff, just bought the eyeshadow palette. And then on September 28th, they launch what I think is probably one of their biggest collections of the year, which was the Disney Princesses collection, really preying on the little girls inside all of us that shop on ColourPop's website. And so they did the Disney collection, still available. I bought the eyeshadow palette and the Belle Lippy. And honestly, the eyeshadow palette is so boring. I'm holding on to it because it is kind of like a collector's item, but honestly, I don't see myself getting any use out of that. And then moving on to the month of October, they were busy in October again. They came out with the Ooh La La palette for October 3rd to celebrate Mean Girls Day, and you know how much everyone likes to wear pink, and October 3rd, and it was a whole thing. It was a beautiful palette. I totally bought it. Again, it doesn't get enough use in my collection, but I love a good matte pink in my crease, so I had to buy it. Then they did a collection for a Make-A-Wish, and that was ColourPop x Delia, or Delilah, and they did a beautiful collection of 4 Super Shocks and some lippies, which I think was beautiful that some girl got to have her wish granted and collab with ColourPop. And then on October 18th, they launched 30 shades of stick foundations, and I was curious to try it, but honestly, it just slowed down my ColourPop purchases, so I did pass on that. And then 10/25, they launched their second collab with Karrueche, I think, and this was the Brown Sugar palette. Again, I was on such a ColourPop eyeshadow palette buying streak, but this palette, I'll throw up a picture obviously, looks so bland and boring that I just did not feel any need to buy that collection. Now we get into November. There's a lot of stuff happening in November. November 9th, they launched their collab with Bretman, I can't remember his name. Is he just Bretman now? I don't know. He's not really my favorite person on the internet, but he did the wet. And what is it? I can't even remember what this collection was called, but he had the 2 eyeshadow palettes, the blushes, the lippies, the glitter thingy. That then they had this huge controversy with Lemonhead glitters. I totally passed on that whole collection. Then they came out with their first holiday collection, which was November 15th. They did the Over the Rainbow or Somewhere on the Rainbow or something. And I bought the palette and a few lippies from that collection because I think they had some unique shades. But that collection was humongous, and I just didn't feel the need to buy everything from that. Then on November 21st, they did their collab with No Kill LA, which is a animal shelter, I believe. And so it's a good cause, but I just won't buy any more Super Shocks from them. It's just a waste of my money, so I passed on that. They also did some lip bundles on November 24th. And then on November 26th, they launched their Super Shock Volt, and this is a $99 Volt collection that has a bunch of beautiful Super Shock shadows, but I felt like this was definitely not gonna get any use from me, so I passed on the whole thing. I haven't actually seen any of my friends or seen if anybody actually that I know bought it, but yeah, I'm sure there are some, you know, big fans of Super Shock shadows that pick those up. Okay guys, so in December, they did not slow down. December 5th, they came out with the Becky G Sauvage collection. I did buy that eyeshadow palette because I was a fool. I thought it was gonna be a little bit more tan girl friendly. It was okay, but nothing really mind-blowing. I do like the teal shades she had in there, but honestly, it feels like every ColourPop palette has a pop of blue or a pop of green, so I do regret picking those up. And then on 12/07, they came out with some mini holiday bundles, probably so you can gift them and get them in time for the holidays for your friends and family. 12/12, they came out with a little collection with Kathleen Lights. It honestly felt like a money grab because it was such an odd collection. I feel like it could have been like a Valentine's collection almost because it was like more pink heavy, and it was called the Twinkling Lights Collection. And then on 12/11, they randomly launched new single Shadows, and I did buy that palette because it was such a good deal. You got 24 new single shadows and a magnetized palette for free. So that was wonderful. And I was actually intending to wear those shades on my eyes, but I ended up using a different ColourPop palette. So if this Get Ready With Me is live, I will go ahead and link it up in the cards for you guys to check out. Otherwise, definitely subscribe to my channel so you can see how I created this look. Then on 12/18, they launched the Rendezvous and Sweet Nothing and a few other palettes that were on Ulta.com on the ColourPop site. So I'm actually wearing the Rendezvous eyeshadow palette on my eyes in case you guys were curious. And then 12/19, I didn't think they would launch a brand new product so late in the year, but on 12/19 they launched some lippy scrubs and some lippy balms. They looked beautiful, but I am not really in the market for either of those products. I have one lip scrub and that's all I need. I don't need any more than what I have, so I didn't buy any of those. And then they dropped a major banger on 12/26. They launched the ColourPop x I Love Sarah E collection. This was round two, and she did a whole collection called like Through My Eyes, and there's lippies and stuff. The one thing that really caught my attention was the eyeshadow palette because it had beautiful green packaging. Green's been like the it color of 2018, and so I feel like they got a little tricky there because there's really only like one green shade, and then the rest was just more boring neutrals from ColourPop. This is my ColourPop rewind video, so I just went through and told you guys everything they launched in 2018. I am exhausted from ColourPop. So I just thought this would be a fun video. Let me know your guys' thoughts down below, what your favorite collections was. Are you gonna be picking anything up from them this year? What are your thoughts? I'm so curious to know. I hope you guys like this idea. Let me know what other brands you would like to see a rewind for. I'm really contemplating doing Kylie Cosmetics, but I'm kind of bored and I really don't want, like, I need to be like really, really bored to like get in the zone to like scroll through somebody's Instagram and pay attention. But yeah, if there's other brands you're curious about, especially ones that are always coming out with things, I would love to do another one of these. So yeah, keep me posted down in the comments. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye guys.